One of the members of the Field Rep 101 community was asking about whether loan signings made sense for him. And of course, like many things, it all depends on your situation. Because for me, I got into field inspections because of loan signings. What it was that another realtor, at the time I was still doing real estate sales, mentioned how he was doing loan signings periodically to earn some cash. And of course, at the time, while I was struggling as a real estate agent and looking to get started, I also was in the same situation. So I looked into it, took a course on how to be a public notary, and signed up for a bunch of directories and stuff like that, and got a little bit into it. And for a while, it was pretty profitable. So the thing about loan signings, like everything else, it takes a little bit of investment of time and money to get it down, to do what you need to and stuff like that. And like anything else, it's like a matter of like deciding how much you can invest into looking into it, into learning what you need to do with it. And I talk more about it in the post that I wrote on Field Rep 101. I'll share that link in the description, and also see if I can also get this on the video as well. The main thing, though, that I would say, out of everything else, out of the specifics of learning what's involved with loan signings, what's involved with getting to become a public notary and stuff like that, is the same thing that's for whether it's field inspections or mystery shopping, is looking at what you're willing to do, how much you can really commit in terms of time, in terms of energy, in terms of intention, attention, and just basically testing. But as I was saying to this Field Rep 101 member, don't do what somebody else is telling you to do. Go as far as you feel that you're ready to commit to it, and you're the best judge. You know, I mean, not, you know, it's not me, it's not some of your friends, or, you know, or even some business guru and stuff like that, who's like kind of basically giving you some, you know, motivational speech and stuff like, and all that. So I talk about how when I was running for the marathon, I listened to somebody else who was pushing me, and I figured, you know, he finished a marathon, so he knew better, you know, how much I need to push myself, or, you know, how much further I need to push. And it turned out that I almost screwed myself. I almost wasted weeks, if not months, of preparation for the marathon by either injuring myself or just, you know, just sidelining myself long enough that I just missed the marathon. Luckily, I recovered in time. Luckily, I was able to run the marathon successfully. But it just, the lesson I learned there was the importance of listening to ourselves and having confidence in our ability to know what's best for us. So that's probably like the biggest thing that I want to share today. And, you know, definitely let me know, like, if you have had situations like that where somebody pushed you, and where you felt maybe that they had more expertise, so you should listen to them, and maybe, you know, in some instances paid the price for it.